Hi, I'm Chris Berman. Ahead on ESPN, the freak, Javon Kurtz. He bolted in free agency this offseason. We'll see if he can be the same impact player in his new digs. I bet you, yes, we'll see. Eagles, Falcons, it's go time.
While the teams are out on the field getting loose, the fans are filing in and finding their seats for the game. Hi there, I'm Dan Stevens, and welcome to the Georgia Dome. At my side, my cohort, Peter O'Keefe. Peter, our game features one of the best wideouts in the game.
Unquestionably, Dan. T.O. is so tough to defend against. He's got that great size for a receiver. He can get up and just out-muscle you for the ball. But that speed is deceptive, too. He's one of the best around, if not the best around.
We'll see how he does once the game begins, Peter. But first, let's go to the coin toss. There's the signal, and we're ready. Akers kicks it off to begin the game. Rossum downs this in the end zone for a touchback.
Come on,
the Falcons send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their own 20-yard line.
We back!
Dunn will get the carry on first down and rambles for about five. Dunn gets the call again and heads out right.
Well, Dunn likes to use his speed, not size. 5'9", 180. This guy's hard to get a handle on. He relies on his agility to move the ball downfield.
Third down, 1 yard to go.
Richter. Throw back.
Finneran has the bullet, and they convert on third down.
Ryan Finneran is matched up well with the defense on this one, but is able to stay one step ahead for the completion. It's worth another look here. Oh, yeah, the D might want to put more men on him next time.
Peter, they did what they needed to do, and they squeak it past the first down line.
Yeah, he knew what he needed to do, and he done did it.
How eloquently put.
Thank you.
Vic throws this other rover, and it's complete at the 43. Finally stopped at the 40. It will be first down.
Michael Vick handles big time on this play, and it works. Makes it a little more exciting to watch, too. Oh, if he wasn't accurate on this throw, it would have been an interception. It's a real fine line.
You better use those feet to scramble, Vic, because you ain't going to get no time in that pocket.
Single back! Down!
Price catches this one, and that's good for six.
Michael Vick laid the pass perfectly, zeroing in on his man despite the coverage. You know, it's all about accuracy in that situation.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Second down from the eye. Dunn has his number called on second down and picks up a couple.
Well, Dunn stuck close to his blockers, but the play folded quicker than an over-caffeinated origami artist.
Not much there, but they'll get another shot on third and short.
Let's go, baby! Get your hands up!
Double play! Down! Set!
gets the call again, and gets tackled short of the markers. Fourth down coming up.
Michael Lewis brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
That's his second tackle so far. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. They take the lead.
Jay Feely really gets the whole ball here, and he needed it. Watch. That's a powerful kick for 3 points, my friend. When he needs to, he can boot that thing.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Feely rockets this one deep. Reed decides to take it out of the end zone. Back down at the 20.
J.R. Reed got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Eagles get their offense on the field and will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Westbrook takes his first carry of the game and picks up a couple.
You better bring it, T.O. You better bring it.
Single back. Pinkston pulls down the floater out left and is at the 30. 10. He's in for the touchdown.
I'm the man.
Todd Pinkston keeps the party going after making the catch right here. And now he's off for more. Coaches love receivers who believe his job is just starting when he makes the catch.
He gets the TD and a little congratulations from his teammates.
It's well deserved, Dan.
The point after, and it's good.
Yeah, give me some, baby. Give me some.
Nice job, baby.
You're going all the way.
Wait a minute, right here. Yeah.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Akers rockets this one deep. Rossum decides to take it out of the end zone. Jukes, tackled at the 20.
Allen Rossum got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Falcons will start this first play of the drive at their own 20-yard line. Dunn takes it for his fifth carry and heads upfield. Brought down at the 25.
Nice one. Yeah.
Second down, 3 wideouts in the game. Griffith goes in motion. Dunn cruises out to the left side and maybe picks up one on the play.
Warwick Dunn had some blocking help on that last one, but he was still left with nowhere to go.
Not a lot of room on that play. It will be third down. Vic zips it to the left sideline, and this one is incomplete.
Lito Shepard slapped around the receiver way too much on that play, and the ref let him know it with a flag for pass interference.
Randy, Crow.
Brown makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Sheldon Brown came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Second down with a split backfield. Vic rifles this one hard over the middle, and it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
Ryan Finneran faces double coverage on this play, but still comes out with the ball. Nice throw and nice catch. Let's take a look. They had him covered well, but he was still able to make the catch. That guy's a great receiver.
Peter, it's early in the game. It's the first time they go deep, and he makes the big completion. What does that do for a team's confidence?
Well, Dan, obviously it's a huge boost, but there's still a lot of game left.
Dunn bulldozes right of center and picks up a couple.
Warrick Dunn had blockers on his side on that last play, but the defense was too smart. It gave him nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were hoping for more.
Dunn takes the handoff and gets past the line. Stopped at the 38. And that'll do it for quarter number one. The Eagles are out in front, 7-3. Third down, and this is the seventh play of the drive. This pass will fall harmlessly to the ground, and it's incomplete. Fourth down coming up. Moore lines up for the punt. Moore takes the snap and aims this one out of bounds. This will fly out of bounds at the 11.
Chris Moore did a good job angling the punt out of bounds, so the offense will start off stuck inside the 20.
The Eagles had an effective first drive, and we'll see if they can keep it up. They'll start at their own 11-yard line. Westbrook is at the 25. Westbrook gains a bunch on the play, and that brings up first down.
Brian Westbrook has a great offensive line in front of him. They made that play happen. Yep, those blockers opened up the hole for him. A huge game.
First down, 10 yards to go. Richie gets the call on first down and heads out right, tackled at the 35.
John Richie sticks to his blockers like a kick me sign as he runs the football.
Well, yeah, that's a pretty vivid description, but I'll tell you, it works, and the play works too as he surges across the line for a big game.
Yeah, it's all about using your blockers, Dan. They clear a path, you use the path.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play. Now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Westbrook picks up a yard on the play, and that brings up third down.
Jason Webster made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
And at the end of that play, Peter, it goes to show you what leverage and good positioning can do when it comes to making the tackle.
Yeah, and you know, Dan, that's especially important when you're outmatched on strength. That's a good play there.
Westbrook gets past the line and converts the third down.
What's wrong with you, Falcons? Stop them!
Shoot the
first down
shoot
and four wideouts in the game.
Dan, bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
Edwards gets the sack way back at the 34.
Vaughn Edwards gets to his man in the backfield for a big loss. I don't know what happened to the protection. Let's have a look. You know, Dan, it's all about focus and persistence. He was not going to let that quarterback get that pass off.
The defensive design worked flawlessly, and the refs will spot the ball well behind the original line of scrimmage.
What a way to derail a series from the onset.
Second and long ahead. Now puts his arm into this one, and it's complete at the 44. Finally dropped at the 35. That will bring up first down.
Donovan McNabb makes a risky pass here and completes it. That took guts, Dan. Check it out. Oh, perfect pass. And it had to be accurate to get in there between the two defenders.
What a pass! And he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, absolutely, Dan. So far, he's got 109 yards and one touchdown.
Smith goes in motion. This one will fall incomplete.
You better bring it, T.O. You better bring it.
McNabb rifles it out left side, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Terrell Owens was the man on that play, coming across the middle, but the ball couldn't find him. Incomplete.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down. It'll be it. Fourth down.
Nothing happening. Nope. Nothing.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Akers launches the 52-yard attempt and has it sail just left of the upright.
Come on. That's right.
David Akers misses the field goal here. Let's watch this again. Yep, it's just a little bit to the side of the upright, but close only counts in horseshoes.
The Falcons could take the lead before halftime as their offense will start at their 43-yard line. Crumpler grabs the fastball over the middle and is well past the markers for a first down.
Watch the counter. Watch the counter.
Gunn goes right up the middle and rambles for about five. Dunn gets the ball again and heads left. Tackled at the 34.
Let's go, Falcons. Let's get that first.
Third down, two wideouts on the field. Price goes in motion.
Goal 52.
Dunn has his number called on third down and picks up the first down.
Work done, played smart, and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
A big gain on third, and they will easily move the chain.
Perfect call for the situation, Dan. No trouble in getting the first.
First down with the tight end right. Dunn gets the toss and runs into traffic. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run.
Stick a fork in him. He's done.
Vic throws a heater, and he connects at the 18. Finally dropped at the 14. First down. First down, three wideouts in the game. It over the middle, and that's a touchdown.
Michael Vick makes a terrific completion in double coverage here. Wow, now that is one confident QB.
Peter, that's his first touchdown pass of the game. How do his stats look?
Well, so far, he's got 107 yards and one touchdown.
Let's go, T! Cover your man!
Now the extra point, and it's good. The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Feely booms a beauty here. Wynn downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 20-yard line. Rips him down in the backfield, and the clock continues to run.
Brady Smith keeps his man from getting back to the line. Let's watch.
Pow! Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Peter, they put an end to that play well in the backfield, and they had a real good read on that.
Yeah, it all starts with the guys up front, Dan, and then everybody follows.
Second down coming up. Second down, one man back. Westbrook will get the carry on second down and gains about 3 yards. Mitchell goes in motion. McNabb airs this one to the left sideline, and it will be first down. First down, and five wide receivers take the field. Mitchell makes the catch out to the left, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
Freddie Mitchell had three guys covering him, but look what happens. Incredible catch.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
And it will be a first down. And that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Falcons with a small lead, 10-7. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
All right, Dan, we'll get back to you in a bit. But welcome, everybody, to the ESPN Halftime Show. I'm Chris Berman. Look at our halftime stats here, and boy, look at the difference in passing yards. The Eagles should be way ahead on the scoreboard, but somehow they've let their opponent hang with them. The Let's see if they can change things in the second half. We'll pick up the action midway through the first quarter. After driving 49 yards on seven plays, J.C. Me Feely sets up for a long one here. He's got plenty of boot behind this one. It's through. A 48-yard field goal. The Falcons strike first and go up by three. Eagles midway through the first. Todd Pinkston came up with a huge play here as they cover a lot of real estate on this one. A 78-yard touchdown for the Eagles. Falcon towards the end of the first quarter. Falcons behind by four. Michael Vick connected with his man on this one. Eagles now in the second quarter. Donovan McNabb is going to spread things around here. He finds his man out of the backfield. A 31-yard play that set up an Eagle field goal, but they couldn't connect. Eagles up 7-3. Michael Vick would find his target on this one. A 14-yard touchdown for the Falcons. The Falcons grab the lead again and go up by three. Eagles coming up on the end of the half. Terrell Owens is going to try to stretch the field here. He's going to make them pay. And that's where we'll leave this one. Falcons are holding on to a lead 10-7. Today's halftime hero has turned in an incredible performance thus far. Todd Pinkston has played like a man possessed. So that'll do it from here. Let's send you back out now to Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe. Dan?
Thanks, Boomer, and welcome back to our broadcast presented in ESPN Game Sound. Designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby, the leader in surround sound technology. The Eagles will receive to start the second half, and this is a tight contest. Currently, they're down 10-7. Now, let's get to the game. Feely boots the second half kickoff away. Wynn catches it back at the 4. Dragged down at the 29. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Well, there's the drive results, and the thing I want to talk about is how close this game is. When the score is like it is, one single mistake can change the whole game. They need to be careful here.
Let's go down to Susie Culber, who has an update for us. Susie?
Thanks, Dan. Head coach Andy Reid talked with us at the half and told us that their offense needs some help. He said, we haven't been able to sustain long drives on offense the way we'd like to. If the defense can get some stops for the upfield, they'll give our offense a chance to put some points on the board. We'll see if the D can answer the call. Dan, back to you.
Susie, thank you. Owens snags the missile and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
I'm coming.
First down, 10 yards to go. McNabb throws a beauty to the right side, and it's tipped.
Hold on, man.
Incomplete.
Heath Brooking got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Mitchell reels in the football and is well past the markers for a first down.
You better bring it, T.O. You better bring it. Single back. Single back.
Richie is at the 10. And touchdown.
Yeah. Come on, get it up. Yeah, baby. Touchdown. Yeah.
John Ritchie sticks close to his blockers here, and it pays off.
Peter, that will put a touchdown in his stat column.
And that's always nice to have, Dan. So far, he's got 33 yards and one touchdown.
The extra point, and it's good.
Yeah, huh? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, keep this thing on me all game. Okay.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Akers rockets this one deep. Rossum downs this in the end zone for a touchback.
That's what I'm talking about, baby. Yeah. That's a good work out there,
all right,
man.
All right, yeah.
The Falcons offense takes the field, and their running game has yet to get on track. We'll see if it happens here as they start at their own 20-yard line. Dunn punches this one left of center and gains about 3 yards.
Okay, fellas, we went over this all week in practice. Now we're going to get it this time. Now we're going to go just like it is. We're going to execute, okay. We're going to stay strong, and we're going to get to the spots we need to. Okay, fellas?
Second down, just a single receiver on the field. Brown blasts him back at the 22.
Sheldon Brown targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long. Price didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Matt Ware had that play dissected before it even started, really. Textbook zone coverage there.
The defense forces fourth down, and even if they had completed the pass,
it still would have been short.
Yes.
You have to run those routes farther in that situation.
Moore gets the ball and punts it away. Mahe fields the punt at the 36. Stopped at the 48.
Reno Mahe racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Eagles offense takes the field, and they are already halfway there. They'll start at their 48-yard line. Grabs the fastball over the middle, and
Jason Webster delivers a punishing blow to the ball carrier there, and he gives up the football for the fumble. Great hard-nosed defensive play.
Peter, there are many ways you can start a drive, but a turnover is not one of them.
No, definitely not. That was a big-time play.
The Falcons want to capitalize on the fumble and will start this drive at their own 30-yard line. Vic throws a bullet to the flat and it's caught at the 32. Brought down at the 37.
Ryan Finneran made the catch without any challenge from the defense, and he took advantage of it.
They move the ball and it will be second down.
Watch the screen.
Dunn has his number called on second down and picks up a couple.
Corey Simon made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
That will be his fourth tackle so far. What do you think of his performance, Peter?
Solid game, Dan. Really carrying his sizable weight out there.
Third down, two tight ends in the game. Crumpler goes in motion. Dunn barrels off his left guard and barely picks up the first down.
Work done. Got a little help from his friends on that play, Dan. They gave him the space he needed to make the play. Great blocking up front.
A nice play, and with only a short distance to the first, they put it together and make it happen.
Yeah, third and short always looks easy, but it's not, Dan. That's good execution.
They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete.
Algie Crumpler had some room on the fringes there, but couldn't reel in the pass.
That falls incomplete, but it would have been a minimal gain had they completed it anyway.
Single back.
pick, zips it to the left sideline, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Matt Ware
came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That'll give us a third down, and the defense was ready for that call.
Well played, and a good job of not giving up the short pass.
Move it back, Vic. Move it back.
Third down, tight end to the left. The first on third and long.
Lewis Price has a guy shadowing him, but still manages to make the catch. He beats his man cold. It's all about staking your turf.
That's broken kind of a cold streak for him. The last two passes his way were incomplete.
Yeah, let's see if he stays on track.
Done. We'll get stopped at the line, and that will bring up second down.
Spread, spread. Larry, Larry, Larry.
It's intercepted. Tackled at the 18.
Well, those were some great instincts back there to get the interception. You can't coach that.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Eagles fumbled the ball away last time. Let's see if they can hold on to it as they start this drive at their own 18-yard line. Rifles this one hard over the middle, and it falls incomplete.
Donovan McNabb is putting on quite a display out there, Dan. He's finding his receivers and getting into a rhythm out there, both with the long and the short ball. He's racked up 237 yards and one touchdown.
Him to drop the ball, incomplete.
Donovan McNabb for an incomplete pass into double coverage. He's got to use better judgment out there.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down. This to the left sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Terrell Owens plays this one perfectly, getting himself to the right place at the right time to make the catch. The defense should be embarrassed that they let this one get away.
Yeah, Peter, they had him double covered, and they still couldn't get to the ball in time. He was just too good for them.
Yeah, he's an incredible receiver. Nothing gets in his way.
Peter, I'm sure he's happy to bring that one in. The last three passes to him have all been incompletion.
Yeah, he's struggling a bit there, but this may turn him around.
Westbrook catches it in the flat, and that's good for six.
Brian Westbrook had nobody on him. The quarterback saw it and got the ball to him.
Definitely a slow start, but he's finally got a completion. And maybe now, Peter, he has time to make his mark on the game.
But where was he in the first half, Dan? Because I didn't notice him on the field at all.
McNabb throws a bullet to the flat, and the catch is made for a gain of
a
couple.
Stop him here, team. Keep him out of field goal range, baby. Down.
Westbrook picks up a yard on the play, and they will be just shy of the markers. Fourth down.
Matt Stewart brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
That's his second tackle so far. And that'll do it for the third quarter. The Eagles are out in front 14-10.
It's fourth quarter. Let's grind it out, D.
Westbrook will get the carry on fourth down and converts the fourth down. What a fantastic play.
Brian Westbrook was assisted on that play by some great blocking that opened up holes for him. Without those blockers, he would have been toast.
They convert the fourth, and there's some excited faces down there on the field.
Oh, boy, nothing can amp up an offense like a big play. That's how you get the first.
And that's what they've got, first down. Westbrook gains five on the play, and that brings up second down. Kingston goes in motion. And I'll tell you what, this looks like it wasn't that difficult to tackle, but he had his hands full.
Yeah, looks can be deceiving, Dan. He really had to square himself perfectly to make that play.
Third down. Ninth play of the drive coming up. The rope right side, and they convert on third down.
Donovan McNabb threw a nice pass past the coverage and got the completion. Tough throw, but an accurate throw.
He adds another completion to his strong numbers today, Peter.
Yeah, he sets the bar pretty high for himself, but I imagine he's happy with his consistent performance today.
McNabb throws a heater right sideline, and he connects at the 18. Finally stopped at the 8. It'll be first and goal.
Todd Pinkston made the catch and iced the cake with a few more yards after that back there. Way to fight for more.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
And it will be a first down.
Look, Dan, great receiving yards there. That will help your fantasy team.
Picks up a yard on the play, and that will bring up second down.
Watch the pass, watch the pass!
Westbrook takes it for his 11th carry and heads wide right. Stopped at the 1.
Oh, what the heck was that?
Hold him down, Dino. Give 6.
Well, then both pass and run are viable, but I wonder if we'll see the quarterback sneak here.
Smith goes in motion. Whips him down in the backfield, and that moves them even farther away from the goal line. That will bring up fourth and goal.
You know,
fourth down, goal to go. Akers with a 21-yarder, and this one is up and
that's
in.
That's what I'm talking about, baby. We're bringing it. I'm bringing it.
David Akers has little trouble pooching this one through. Let's see it again. Yep, he knows that you aren't allowed to miss many of those in this league.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Akers booms a beauty here. Rossum decides to take it out of the end zone. Brought down at the 22. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. How they turned the ball over leaps out at me, and you have to think that that could come back to haunt them. Turnovers are the most telling stat in the NFL. Allen Rossum took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on
what
that play.
The Falcons were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their own 22-yard line. Dunn chews up 4 yards, and that brings up second down. Finneran didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Michael Vick has had a number of pass attempts. We've seen that his guys are out there running their routes and trying to make plays. He would like to do a little bit more, however. So far, he's got 144 yards and one touchdown.
Third down, empty backfield. Vic zings it to the right side. The reception's made at the 36. And he stopped right there. First down. First down from the eye. This one way out right, and he stopped. The clock continues to run. Dunn chews up 4 yards. The clock will continue to run. Dunn carries it for a third time in a row. Converts the third down.
Mark Simoneau clearly tugs on the face mask here. You just can't do that and get away with it. Check it out. Yep, there's the flag. Definite face mask. That's a personal foul.
First down, the clock is stopped at 1:29. Dunn picks up about 2, and that will bring up second down. Second down, 2 wideouts on the field. Him down in the backfield, and that will take them out of field goal range.
Wow, look at those tackles. That's how you play sideline to sideline.
Vic fires this one over the middle, and it's tipped. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Michael Lewis came in and got a hand on that football. It left no chance for a reception there.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Interceptor! Tackled at the 30.
Matt Ware shows why you think twice before throwing a pass in his neighborhood. Watch. Great presence of mind to try for the football there.
Well, that's their second interception of the game, and stingy is appearing to be the motto for their defense.
Yeah, either that or give me the ball.
The Eagles start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 49. Westbrook gets the handoff and searches for the Falcons. Take their first timeout. Second down, 5 yards to go. Westbrook picks up. The Falcons will take a timeout. That's their second. Third down, the clock is stopped at 40. Owens goes in motion.
19.
Westbrook gets the call on third down, and the Falcons take a timeout. That's their final one.
Better hope I don't get my
Johnson
fingertips
gets
on that
ready
ball.
To punt this away. Johnson takes the long snap and punts it away. Fields it at the 22. Dragged down at the 27.
D'Angelo Hall got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Falcons start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 27. Vic throws a bullet, and this one is incomplete.
All day, baby. All day. You ain't getting nothing.
What are you gonna do? Second down with a split backfield. Simoneau tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Mark Simoneau came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their sixth so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
Third down, the clock is stopped at 21. Vic throws a heater right sideline and it's tipped. Incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
No way you're gonna convert this.
This one falls incomplete, and they will turn the ball over on downs.
Fearless Price was wide open, but he can't get the pass. What a killer.
That was some aggressive play calling that deep in their own territory, and it may have cost them dearly.
I just don't see how they were in four down mode there, especially at their end of the football field. That's a bad call. Hardly any time on the clock for them to do anything, Dan. The only bright spot is that they have all three of their timeouts left. That last play wasted enough time to allow them to run out the clock now. All they need to do is sit on it, and this game is in the bag.
And that is going to do it for this one. The Eagles come out on top 17-10. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
Hey, nice job. Hey, nice job,
good
guys.
Game.
Good job.
Good job.
Okay, Dan, thank you very much. And let's welcome all of you back to the studio. I'm Chris Berman here to bring you our ESPN Video Games post-game wrap-up. The Eagles stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. John Ritchie is going to bounce this one to the outside. And look at the execution up front. He's in the clear. A 24-yard touchdown for the Eagles. The Eagles take their first lead in the half and go up by four. This time at the 30, Keith Brookings is going to have a beat on this one. It's a fumble. He's right there to get his hands on it. The Falcons, after recovering a fumble, Falcons trailing by four. Donnie Jones was in the right place at the right time, as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. The Eagles have it off an interception. Donovan McNabb would find his target on this one. That set up an easy 22-yard field goal. Eagles out in front, 17-10. Matt Ware is reading the quarterback's eyes all the way as he's able to get his hands on this one and pick it off. And that's where we'll leave this one. Eagles squeaked out a win, 17-10. Now let's catch up with the player who really ignited his team's offense with his deft passing and has earned our Player of the Game award. Donovan McNabb is standing by with Susie Kalber. Suze?
Thanks, Chris. You were fantastic. And you won a close game today. What gave you guys the edge today?
This is how we do as we always do it. We come together as a team and give it our all. My teammates really helped me out. I couldn't ask for a better group of guys to play alongside. I'm just happy to get the W and ready to move on to next game.
Back to you, Chris.
That winds up our broadcast of the NFL preseason on ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports for 25 years and counting. I'm Chris Berman. Thanks for joining us.